Hello, everyone. I'm Luis Leon. I'm a program manager in the Azure AD engineering team.
I'm Jairo Cadena, also a PM on the same team.
Today, we're going to talk on how you can migrate your apps to Azure AD. First, we're going to see the benefits of bringing your apps to Azure AD, how you can think about this project, and what are the tools available in Azure AD to help you get started. Traditionally, users, devices, data, and apps have resided and been protected within the corporate network. With the arrival of the cloud, we now have an ecosystem of users across multiple platforms. These users access these apps from any vast range of devices and locations, and new apps are being used, developed, and retired every day. You want to enable your users and partners to access the applications to collaborate and be productive. But as these accesses span outside your corporate network, you also want to keep your resources secure. Azure AD offers a universal identity management system that provides your people, partners, and customers a single identity to securely access all the applications they need from any platforms and device. With Azure AD, you can increase productivity by managing a single identity for each user across cloud and on-prem environment. Leverage self-service capabilities to empower end users to get access to the resources they need at the right time. You can manage costs by reducing the dependencies on on-premises license and infrastructure. In some cases, you may have already paid for Azure AD via M365 license. So why pay for an additional cost of another identity access management solution? You can manage risk by improving secure user access to applications and corporate data using conditional access policies, multi-factor authentication, and real-time risk-based identity protection technologies. You can address compliance to regulatory requirements by enforcing corporate access policies and monitoring user access to applications and associated data using the audit logs. So Jairo, how does it sound to you? Should customer move the apps to Azure AD and enjoy all the benefits I mentioned?
Luis, that's a great idea, most definitely.
So based on your experience working with customers, how they can start thinking about this migration project?
Well, you'll see, Luis, when I talk to customers, one of the first things that they think about is a staged plan how to get there. Well, you'll see that there are multiple applications that they don't even know that they have, that their users are using on a day-to-day basis. So they need a discovery plan. They need a way to discover all those applications that they need to protect eventually. Once they have discovered those applications, they need to think about how they are going to classify and plan those applications, whether those apps need to be modernized, where those apps can be migrated and basically replaced by modern versions of those applications, whether they have applications in ADFS or some other third-party identity providers that they can very easily move to Azure AD, or whether they have applications that are legacy in nature, that they have these protocols like Kerberos or header-based authentication or form-based authentication, any of these legacy protocols that they can actually publish for remote access through the Azure AD application proxy or through one of our partnerships that we have announced very recently as well, be it F5 Big IP APM, or it could be CScaler CPA, or it could be Citrix NetScaler, or Akamai. Any of these options is a comprehensive way that customers can start thinking about the plan on how to move these applications to Azure AD. I hope this gives you an idea on how to get started with your migration project. In the next video, Luis is going to demo how to use the ADFS application activity report to migrate applications from ADFS to Azure AD. Until next time.